about close to an hour with the parents of the Sibley, and there's one thing the father, in the midst of all his grief, there are a few things that stand out. Mr. Nayak is with us, and there's one of the things, the most important thing that he said was that he says, look, I've lost my daughter, but the situation in Goa is such that the law and order situation is terrible, and I've lost my daughter, and I don't want anyone to go through what I've had to go through. And he said that there are so many unanswered questions, because I dropped her off at the Mapsa bus stop at 9:30 in the morning. I received a call from the hotel saying she hadn't reached work. At 12 o'clock, I filed a missing persons report. The body was ostensibly washed ashore in Kalingut and was discovered unclothed, and when she left the house, she was fully clothed, obviously. It was, and she was wearing, from what I understand, jeans and a top, so it's not something that could have disintegrated in the water. And she was found unclothed on the beach. The police only informed him at about 5 o'clock the next evening. After tourists on the beach and people on the beach had already seen her, they didn't really cover her up. And he said that the harassment that he faced after, because he seems to be under the impression that there's a direct link between the investigative authorities at the site and between higher officials and the highest levels of government. And he says that there are a few unanswered questions. One, the postmortem says death by drowning. The fact is that the viscera, they seem to have treated it as a normal case of unnatural death. They seem to have completely ruled out foul play initially, which is why they didn't preserve the viscera. The body has since been cremated, so there is nothing to investigate further. The second thing he says that if she had indeed drowned, then there would have been swelling in the body, there would have been sand inside. The postmortem report clearly says that the sand is only in the, just at the, in the throat and in the trachea, nothing in the stomach. Stomach is clear. There is no swelling on the body. There are bruises on the legs near the ankles, and it is not completely consistent. And the police are saying that it's a case of suicide. Now, what the father says is this. He says, you can say that death is by drowning. That's only what a postmortem can say. A postmortem can't tell you if it's murder or suicide. Whereas the police investigation should conclude that what led to the death, which the police investigation has not done. They've closed the investigation, and the Goa police seem to be incapable of doing a proper investigation into this. They have not followed standard operating procedure. And he's, and we agree with everything that he said, and he seems to think that we cannot get justice out of this government because everybody is hand in glove in trying to cover this up. And because there was a big social outcry is even why they filed an FIR. Initially, they were not even willing to take.
Was not done with the norms that should be followed. One, at least three doctors should be present. The entire postmortem procedure should be covered by CCTV camera, and a portion of the viscera, since it was a contentious issue, should have been preserved. And that's one thing. The second thing is that under pressure, the government had formed a three-member committee, investigation committee, to check on the postmortem and to examine the case. They again reiterated that it was a case of drowning, but they said that further investigation should be done. That was not done. So I think that a middle-class family is not getting the, it's just because they are not mighty enough to go to court and fight against the government. Because he said a very serious thing. I understand a little bit of Marathi, having stayed in Bombay, that there seemed to be a direct connection between the police officer and the topmost person in the state. They had a direct conversation, and it was immediately ruled out as a normal unnatural death and a case of suicide. Now, anyone after getting COVID could search anything in the about after effects of COVID, whether it is depression, whether it could be losing weight, whether it could be getting some kind of nausea, anything, the brain not functioning. There's several things. I lost my own mother by corona, so I know what these things are. That does not establish anything. Whether searching about depression on the mobile phone can easily say that she was depressed and therefore committed suicide. So proper investigation must be done. And though they have destroyed the viscera and everything else, I think if there is honesty and acknowledgement by the government that their investigation needs to be done, I think a lot of things may come out, as we have seen in the case of Scarlett Keeling. When she died in 2008, her mother insisted for a CBI inquiry, and that was done. So why not?